I'm back with just the table about students this time. I've added one more column to the table, buddy ID. See, I decided that every student should have a buddy, somebody that they can pair up with, do assignments with, study with, all of that. Now, the buddy ID is what it sounds like. It's an ID that relates to the ID of the student that they're buddied up with. So, for example, here, Peter is buddied up with 2, and 2 is Alice. Let me just do a select that should make that more clear. So select the ID, first name, last name, buddy ID from students. Okay. The interesting thing here is that this buddy ID is a column in a table that's related to another column in the same table. That's a bit different from before, where we'd have columns related across different tables. So, what if we wanted to show the names of each student next to the email of the buddy? Not just the ID, the email. To do that, we need to actually join the students table with itself, because the two bits of related data that we need both happen to be in the same table. We can do that by, let's see, so we want the first name, last name, email. So to join students with itself, we're going to write from students and then join students. So we get an error. First name is an ambiguous column. And that's true. We're telling to select first name, but it's joining across two tables, and both of these tables have the same column names. And before, we would just prefix these with the table names, but we can't do that here because actually they're both named students. So we need to give it a way to distinguish between this one and this one, even if they're kind of the same thing. And we can do that by giving one of them an alias. So we're going to write the alias right after here. The alias is like a nickname. So here's the alias, buddies. And then we just have to specify that the email is coming from buddies.email. Haha. There we go. Now we're seeing too many rows, way too many rows. And that's because we don't have an on clause yet. So it's just joining every possible row with every other one. Now our on should check that the buddy ID from the students table, that first one, matches the ID from the second table, buddies, or what we called buddies. Haha! Now we can see Peter with Alice's email address, Alice with Peter's, etc., etc. To make this results table even a little more clear, I'm going to rename buddy's email as buddy email. Okay, so now it's a lot more clear that we're looking at Peter Rabbit and his buddy's email. Cool. Now, this type of join is called a self-join, and that's because it's a table being joined to itself. You can try this out in the next challenge, and I'll show you one more way to use self-joins in the talk through after. I hope you'll join me. If not, just join yourself.